up? It's your boy T-Bear, Henry Ash, and today's Music Monday. So about to get into Rhythm Roulette, as we have a news poll for a new set of Rhythm Roulette to react to. And majority of these are newer ones, including a couple that came out earlier this week, as well as this week and month, as well as a couple that came out last month, as one that came out 3 months ago as well, too, including somebody who's pretty big in TikTok right now as well, too, with their music. But anyway, the choices we had were Power Pleasant, who's best known for his work with Pro Era, Sean Money, and if I recall, Sean Money maybe is part of Disturbing the Peace. I could be wrong. No, I'm wrong. Sean Money. I named something familiar. I thought Disturbing the Peace, but I could be wrong. What is he known for? He mainly with GNU in it and East Coast Forever. I'm thinking of somebody else then that worked with Disturbing the Peace. But anyway, Joji, who's known, I told you, really known, is been known recently with his TikTok song, TikTok viral hit, Glimpse of You. And as well as another two new ones, another new one came out that's Take a J Trip and Molly Rog, seeing like a cool person. So anyway, bottom results of the current results, you know what these, I do these in orders of the results. So other than that, no. Yeah, so going forward, we react to all five in results of the order. And the first one we react to will be Power Pleasant. So you know I said Power Pleasant is best known for working with being part of the Pro Era with Joey Badass, Kurt Knight, and many others though. And this will be the third producer from the Pro Era gang I'm reacting to though. Though as well, I think it's probably fourth and more, at least the fourth person that's part of the Beast Coast in general, included Eric Art. But as for Pro Era, I did Chuck Stranger, I did Kurt Knight not too long ago. Now we're doing Power Pleasant, so you know, Power Pleasant is my dude. So without further ado, is that gang I roll with? No, I don't roll with, but like I fucks with their music. So without further ado, let's check out Power Pleasant's Mass Appeal. Was actually one of the newest Mass Appeal Rhythm Roulette episode that came on, I think, sometime this week. So let's get it. Powers Pleasant, sorry.
Ayo, it's the kid Powers Pleasant. We here in Hollywood at the Record Parlor. And we're gonna play a game of Rhythm Roulette. Mass Appeal, you dig?
And he also is their tour DJ as well, too. One of their tour DJs along with Static Selector. Yeah, I know when my eye lit up, right? Let me see if I catch in the right moment. You know when my eye lit up. Y'all see that, right? If he is one of them beat them albums, oh man, but that triumph. Woo! Hopefully he won them with his album he did rap, but he probably put it back down, so I don't know.
We got Candy Station Chance. This shit look like it got some fire on here, no lie. I'm not gonna hold you. Jimmy Smith, Any Number Can Win. That's a fizz. Look at this player right here in this mobile. Mm-hmm. That should fly. And The Rads, it's the rock one. I'm not familiar, but this shit was hard. Recorded in Australia. We about to go to the studio and make some bangers.
Let's see how you do this, Powers.
We in the studio, we got our three records. Right here, I got the Candy Station Chance. I feel like we're gonna have some fire on this joint right here. Let's see.
See, I got control. the he got the Ableton push, nice. Hey, oh, he got the Serato joint I got. That thing the joint I got. He got the joint I got, the Serato joint I got.
Super disco shit. All right, that was Chance, Candy Station, and I Live number two. I think that was the one. That shit was fire. I'm gonna try to use like all these in one beat. We're gonna see what we could do, but it's like earmarking some stuff, but still trying to figure it out. Sounds some Austin Powers type shit. Yeah, I don't know about this one. The Rads, it's a rock album. That's kind of cool. Maybe something in there? I don't know, but I think we got enough to work with.
We got stuff, but props to him using straight keyboard only with as in like laptop keyboard only with doing the sample thing, because I always say hats off to him, man, because that's tough.
I was kind of going back and forth between what sample I wanted to use, but I went back to the first one. This shit sounds more fire and shit. Now I'm just like building some drums around it, chopped it up a little bit, found a nice loop. I'm just fucking around. Up, I don't know, I was adding other parts. I was doing like arrangement, doing different sections, just tweaking little things. But Gotta add this right here real quick. So I had this sample right here. Then for this part right here, I pitched it down. Then I chopped it up for this part. Then in the beginning, when I first started, I was kind of more on some hip hop shit. Then I went to some trap shit and I kind of just put them together.
Woo! You made two versions. That's awesome. You should make two versions of it. That's all. It's tough right here.
Ayo, it's the kid Powers Pleasant. Got the beat by Powers. And you're watching Rhythm Roulette with Mass Appeal. You dig?
So this is a good episode right here. This definitely was indeed a good episode right here. He killed that beat though. You know, I was thinking he also did stuff for, that's the reason I also paid him with Beast Coast as well too, because he did produce stuff for Pro. He's part of Pro Era, did produce stuff for them, but I was thinking he said let's DJ for Pro Era, but he was DJing for Underachiever. He was their DJ. But that when I remember the Up and Spoke tour I went to, the first one, the one name was in Philly. At the time, it was the main people of the Up and Smoke tour. But yeah, they was their DJ. But other than that, this was a good episode right here as well too of it. So other than that, if you like my reaction, like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's your boy T-Bear signing off. One love.